Good morning, dear students. How are you all? Hope all are fine. Dear students, we are going to see now Unit 2, Standard 6th, Unit 2, The Clothes Line. Okay, the name of the poem is The Clothes Line. Let us read out the poem. Hand in hand, they dance in a row, hither and thither and to and fro. Flip, flap, flop, and away they go. Fluttering creatures as white as snow. Like receptive horses they caper and prance. Like fairy tale witches they wildly dance. Rounded in front but hollow behind. They shiver and skip in the merry match wind. One I saw dancing excitedly. Struggling so wildly till she was free. Then leaving pegs and clotheslines behind her, she flew like a bird and no one can find her. I saw her gleam like a sail in the sun, flipping and flapping and flopping for fun. Nobody knows where she now can be, hid in a ditch or drawn in the sea. She was my handkerchief. Not long ago, but she'll never come back to my pocket, I know. So, dear students, this poem is written by Charlotte Druitt Cole. The poet's name is Charlotte Druitt Cole. Okay. So, dear students, this poem is describing the clothes. Okay. The clothes which is shown here in different ways. So let us see the first stanza. Hand in hand they dance in a row, hither and thither and to and fro. Flip, flap, flop, and away they go. Fluttering creatures as white as snow. In this poem, dear students, the poetess, okay, who has written this poem, describing the clothes on a clothesline in a very imaginative way. Okay, she is imagining. Now exactly it is not happening what is written in the poem, but she is just imagining and telling us. She said that clothes appear as if they are dancing. Okay, dancing hand in hand in a row. You know what is row now. Okay, they also move quickly in many different directions, making a flapping noise. Flapping noise is like making one kind of noise. She calls them fluttering creatures. Okay, she is calling them fluttering. Now, what is the meaning of fluttering? The fluttering means moving lightly and quickly. Okay, moving lightly and quickly. That are as white as snow, which are as white as snow. Now, dear students, you must have seen in the movies the clothes, okay, which no one is there inside, but they are just like hanging somewhere. Now, so many movies you must have seen the ghost. Okay, sometimes they are showing the person, sometimes they are showing black person, sometimes they are showing white, full like white gown up to touching to the ground. Okay, so this is the one kind of story which is telling us about the clothesline. Okay, dear students, this which is telling about the clothesline. So there is a one kind of cloth, okay, which the poet is describing in this poem. Like receptive horses they caper and prance, like fairy tale witches they wildly dance. Rounded in front but hollow behind, they shiver and skip in merry match wind. Now, what is the meaning of witch here? You know, dear students, what is witch? Okay, so they first remind her of restless horses. Okay, so the poem poetess is telling it is reminding her of restless horses which are jumping. Okay, which are jumping and moving quickly. And then of fairy tale witches. Now, you must have heard so many fairy tales. Dancing wildly witches. They are rounded in front of but are hollow behind. As they shiver and dance in the cheerful March wind. Now merry means cheerful, okay, happy. One I saw dancing excitedly, struggling so wildly till she was free. Then leaving pegs and clotheslines behind her, she flew like a bird and no one can find her. The poet saw one of the clothes dancing excitedly. Excitedly means singing and dancing. Struggling wildly till she was free. So she was struggling to become free. Then she flew like a bird, leaving the pegs and clotheslines behind. Now, dear students, the meaning of pegs is clips of wood or plastic to attach wet clothes to the clothesline. So she left everything and she freely she flew away, flapping in the fern. I saw her gleam like a sail in the sun, flipping and flapping and flopping for fun. Nobody knows where she now can be, hid in a ditch or drowned in the sea. So the poet is telling when these clotheslines flew away, it was very happy, cheerful. Okay, we even don't know where she is going. Nobody knows where she is now, whether she is hiding in the ditch or whether she is drowning in the sea or sinking in the sea. She was my handkerchief not long ago, but she'll never come back to my pocket, I know. The poet remarks that the piece of cloth, okay, the piece of cloth was her handkerchief. Now this cloth lines, the heading of the poem is the cloth lines. So this cloth lines is telling us about the handkerchief which is in the poet's pocket, okay. Not long ago, but she knew that she would now never come back to her pocket. So poet was telling us about the handkerchief in this pocket. So yes, students, we have seen this 2.1 poem, the clothesline. Okay, without this poem, we cannot be aware of this poem. Thank you.